Hi guys, just like we said on the previous video, we're going to be teaching you strategies on how to tackle Euclidean geometry. Right, so for starters, we're doing question 9 from the November DBE 2018, question 9.2, right? So the question says, in the diagram, a smaller cycle ABTS and a bigger cycle BDRT are given. BT is a common chord, and then straight lines STD and ATR are drawn. Chords AS and DR are produced. Where's DR? DR are produced, right? To meet in C, right? And a point outside the two cycles. And then BS and BD are drawn. BS and BD are also drawn. And then we're given that A is equals to X and R1 is equals to Y, right? So the first step I'm going to give you is to read the statement, right? Read the statement. So reading the statement helps you identify what is it that you need to know regarding the question, right? While reading the statement, be critical about it. Being critical about the statement means that you have to highlight all the important notes, right? So one note that is important on this one is that you are given that these are just lines, right? So anything that has to do with a tangent or anything like that, forget about it. It is not applicable in this instance, right? Now, the second step you need to do is to identify all theorems that are available in this diagram, right? So what do? We identify theorems in the diagram, right? Excuse me. So looking at these two cycles, one theorem you can identify, if you look at cycle ASTB, that's your theorem 5, right? Theorem 5 says that this angle, that angle are supposed to be equal, right? Angles are subtended by the same chord, right? Same applies to this angle and that angle. They're supposed to be equal. Why? They're subtended by arc AB, right? You go to the next circle. If you check this circle, you have BTRD touching all four corners touching a point on the circumference. So that gives you your cyclic quad. What do you know about a cyclic quad? This angle and that angle are supposed to be equal, right? This angle is supposed to be, these two are supposed to be equal, reason being opposite angles of a cyclic quad. And then this angle is supposed to be that angle. Interior angle of a cyclic quad is equal to the exterior opposite angle, right? This angle is equal to that angle. Same reason to be provided as the one that I have mentioned before. So that is number two. You identify all of the theorems, right? With number two, you can simply incorporate number three, which is what? Identifying all the common angles. Identifying all knowns, actually, right? You identify all the knowns, all the known angles. So if you check on this diagram, we're given that angle A is given by X, right? If you go back to identifying all known theorems, you'll know that this angle and that angle are equal. So angle A is equals to angle B1, which are both equals to X. Why is it so? Just like we said on identifying all the theorems, this is your angle subtended by same chord, right? It is very imperative for you to identify which chord are you talking about so that your marker can be able to see what is it that you're talking about. So I said same chord. Which chord is that? Chord ST. You identify the chord ST. This is the chord that is subtending A and B1, right? Then from there, you're given that angle R1 is equals to Y. So remember that we spoke of a cyclic quad. We said that BTRD is a cyclic quad, meaning that this angle and that angle, B2, they have to be the same, right? So angle R1 is equals to angle B2, which are both equals to y. Right. Why is it so? Opposite angles, I mean interior, opposite angle of cyclic quad. Identify again which cyclic quad are you talking about. Right now we're talking about cyclic quad BTRD. Right. So we have identified all the known angles. Right. Now, the last point or tip I'm going to give you is to identify all the common angles. Identify all common angles. Right. While at that, you can simply apply the concept that you've learned in grade 9, sum of angles in a triangle, alternate angles, corresponding angles. Apply all of that knowledge. It should help you find almost everything on this diagram, right? So on identifying all common angles, from this angle alone, R1, we can identify what is R2, right? So R2 will be given by 180 minus y. How do we know that? Sum of angles in a straight line. Right, and then again, we have identified that this is x, right? We know that this angle and that angle are the same, right? And then from there, what else can we say? I think that's all you need to know for now. But technically, what you need to know is knowing how to identify all of the theorems. From the theorems, be able to identify all of the unknowns. From the unknowns, be able to identify all common angles. That should technically help you to ace a Euclidean geometry question. From this, I can guarantee you, if the question is out of 12, you have 9. Just by doing this. Have a lovely evening. Thank you. Before I forget, I nearly forgot. On the next video, we're gonna be answering the questions on this. Remember that on this video, we're showing strategies on how to tackle a problem. The next video, we're gonna be answering the questions. So remember to subscribe, like the page, and share it with your friends. Thank you.